वेलकम, वी आर डूइंग क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम टॉपिक्स डिजाइनिंग ऑफ फिल्टर्स यूजिंग ऑप एम्प. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज आस्क्ड व्हिच फिल्टर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय सर्किट बिलो. सो दिस क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन 2008 एंड फोर ऑप्शंस वर लो पास फिल्टर, बैंड पास फिल्टर, बैंड रिजेक्ट फिल्टर और हाई पास फिल्टर. सो व्हेन वी हैव सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस देन देयर आर टू मेथड्स टू सॉल्व दीस क्वेश्चंस. So first I will be discussing method 1. So in method 1, what we will do it? We will do first the low frequency analysis. At low frequency analysis. So at low frequency, inductor is replaced by short circuit. As at low frequency, inductor or L is replaced by short circuit. And capacitor is replaced by open circuit at low frequency. So if I replace inductor by short circuit here, then this will become like this. And if I replace capacitor with open circuit here, it will become like this. So this is your open circuit capacitor. And this is your short circuit inductor. Okay, so this is the open circuit capacitor and the short circuit is inductor. So this is now equivalent to your simple non-inverting op amp. Sorry, this is equivalent to a simple inverting op amp. This circuit is now of a simple inverting op amp. Simple inverting op amp, the basic configuration of inverting op amp. And in inverting op amp, the gain is equivalent to minus this resistance upon this resistance. So gain is minus of R upon R. The gain will be equal to minus of R upon R, where the R in the numerator is this feedback resistor and the R in the numerator is this feedback resistor and R in the numerator. This will be R upon R. So R in the numerator is this feedback resistor and R in the denominator is this resistor. Okay, so this gain is equal to minus 1. The gain is equal to minus 1. So V naught will be equal to minus V in. So at low frequency, V naught is equal to minus V in. Now we will do high frequency analysis. So at high frequency analysis, inductor is replaced by open circuit. In high frequency analysis, inductor is replaced by open circuit and capacitor is replaced by short circuit. Okay, in low frequency analysis, inductor was short and capacitor was open. But in high frequency analysis, opposite happens. So inductor is open in high frequency analysis and capacitor is short circuit. So now we will do opposite. We will open the inverter. We will open the inductor. So the inductor is open circuit and your capacitor is short circuit in high frequency analysis. In low frequency analysis, this inductor was short and capacitor was open. But in high frequency analysis, inductor is open and capacitor is short. Okay, so now this is short circuit, so there is no need of this resistance R because it is in parallel with the short circuit. So we can remove this resistance R. So this voltage will be equal to V naught. This voltage will be equal to V naught. And this voltage is 0 volt because it is connected to ground. So by virtual ground concept, V naught will be equal to 0 volt. By virtual ground concept, V naught will be equal to 0 volt. Because this is short circuit, so this voltage is V naught here. At this point, voltage is V naught. So at this point also, voltage will be V naught because it is short circuit. And by virtual ground concept, this voltage is 0 volt. So this V naught will also be equal to 0 volt. So at high frequency, V naught is equal to 0 volt and at low frequency, V naught is equal to minus V in. So this is actually a low pass filter. This is a low pass filter. Okay, so by using method 1, we have found out that this is a low pass filter. Now we will do method 2. In method 2, what we will do is, we will assume that all the components value is 1. The value of all the components is 1. So what we are assuming is, let R equal to 1 ohm, L equal to 1 Henry, and C equal to 1 Farad. Okay, so let me draw inductor. This is 0 volt. This is your resistance, this is capacitance, this is inductor. So we are assuming that this resistance and this resistance is of 1 ohm, and this inductance is 1 Henry, and this capacitance is 1 microfarad. So let Z2 be the impedance of parallel combination of this C and R. Z2 is equal to impedance of this parallel combination of C and R. So impedance of capacitor is 1 upon S, and resistance of R is obviously 1. So 1 upon S parallel with 1. So it will be equal to 1 into 1 upon S upon 1 plus 1 by S. So this is equal to 1 upon S plus 1. So Z2 is equal to 1 upon S plus 1. And Z1 is, let Z1 equal to impedance of series combination of R and L. So Z1 is equal to 1 plus S, because this inductance is 1 Henry, so its impedance will be S, and resistance is 1 ohm. So this is equal to 1. So Z1 is equal to 1 plus S, and Z2 is equal to 1 upon S plus 1. So this is Z1, and this is Z2. So now this is equivalent to a inverting op amp with gain equal to minus of Z2 upon Z1. So this is equal to inverting op amp with gain minus Z2 upon Z1. So Z2 is equal to 1 upon S plus 1, and Z1 is also equal to S plus 1. Z2 equal to 1 upon S plus 1, and Z1 is also equal to S plus 1. So this will equal to minus 1 upon S plus 1 square. Okay. So for low frequency, put S equal to 0. For low frequency, put S equal to 0. So it gives you gain equal to minus 1. So gain, or if you want to take mod of gain, then mod of gain is equal to 1. Okay. And at high frequency, put S equal to infinite. So it will give you gain equal to 0. So again, we have reached similar concept that low frequency is passed with gain equal to 1, and high frequency is blocked with gain equal to 0. So at high frequency, we do not have any output because gain is 0. And at low frequency, output is equal to input. At low frequency, output is equal to input because gain is equal to 1. Gain is equal to output voltage upon input voltage. Output voltage upon input voltage. So at low frequency, gain equal to 1 means output voltage is equal to input voltage. So low frequency is passed. Low frequency is passed. But high frequency is blocked. Low frequency is passed, but high frequency is blocked, because at high frequency gain is equal to 0. So if you put gain equal to 0, you will get output voltage equal to 0. So you are not getting any output when gain is, you are not getting any output at high frequency. So high frequency is blocked, and low frequency is passed where mod of gain is equal to 1. Don't bother about gain equal to minus 1, because minus 1 gains just means a 180 degree phase shift. Okay, minus sign only indicates 180 degree phase shift, nothing else. Okay, minus sign only indicates 180 degree phase shift. So phase will be shifted with 180 degree, but the signal will be passed. So this is a low frequency, this is a low pass filter, and which passes low frequencies and blocks high frequencies. So I hope you got the video. If you have any doubt, you can post your comment in the comment box. Please like and share the video, and also share the video with your friends, and subscribe the channel. And if you have any feedback to share, you can also post your feedback in the comment box. I am reading all the feedbacks. Thank you and best of luck.